It's me, Basketball 79. Bunch of PS1 games. I can just walk in and out of thrift store. Hello, gamers. It's me, Bicepiller 79. It's my show. Glad to be back, man. Hello, gamers. It's me, Bicepiller 79. It's my show. Glad to be back to do another video. I wanted to get into a few things that's been going on for me. As you noticed, I took a few weeks off from my channel, mostly because I needed a break. And really, the last video you guys saw, I shot that back in January. I just mixed it in with current videos that I was shooting. So that one just kept getting pushed. I just had videos back in my backlog or whatever the case may be. But I actually just got bombarded with so much that I needed to take a break. You know, I go through my ups and downs where I'm kind of feeling blue or whatever, or going through depression or whatever the case may be. And it actually just all became too much. I was just frustrated with a lot of things. There was some disappointments that happened. I missed out on a job opportunity. Some things just started changing around me as far as how I was beginning to feel about gaming. I was starting to have a distaste for playing video games, and I wanted to just take a moment, step aside for a second, and get back to the essence of why I loved video games and why I love doing this channel and why I love coming back and the feedback. And, you know, I've had a lot of people, a lot of good people around me that just gave me encouraging words and stuff like that, that led me to just take a break, just to breathe a little bit and see how it is to just step away for a little while. So actually, I probably haven't shot a video in like 3 weeks. I'm probably just going to do straight upload on this and not really do much editing. I think I just got bombarded with the whole nine of having to keep up with the shooting the video, coming up with the ideas, editing videos, putting the thoughts and ideas together, uploading it to YouTube, getting it out to the interwebs, on social media, other websites that I'm linked up with, and trying to end this partnership and stuff like that, taking all my commercial ads down because I figured that was a nuisance, and I just didn't feel like there was no need to even keep those up any longer. I wasn't really benefiting from it. So with that aspect, that was one reason why I stepped aside for a little while, because, I mean, there was a lot of interesting things that have happened. And, you know, I really have had some in-depth conversations with a lot of good people. And that's really, really helped me out. A lot of people just been backing me up, like my homeboy Demetrius and my boy Steven and my buddy Sean and my buddy Corey and my buddy Gary. They all, and of course my family and stuff like that, my wife, and you know, they're just, I've actually just been really, really going through some stuff, and I've been trying to get back the feeling of just being happy. And I actually got depressed and started feeling down, and there's a lot of things that just didn't happen for me. What's crazy is that it's probably been almost 10 years now, or actually it's like 8 or 9 years ago. My wife and I tried to have kids and it didn't work out. We went through in vitro and stuff like that, and we tried to do the insemination and all that. And in the course of that, the baby died and she almost died. She had gotten real ill and stuff like that, and her stomach has swelled up to the size of a 9-month pregnant woman. So that was rough. And then going through foster care and being let down with the disappointment of the foster situations not working out. So it's just been one countless reminder of disappointments, or not necessarily disappointments, just things not going the way I expected them to go, and then with things coming up. And so the combination of dealing with that, and then I got my normal job. You know, for those that don't know, I'm a software tech or technician. So my job is mental, and I'm in the midst of trying to work on getting a promotion. So it's just like everything is just in a whirlwind. I feel like I can tell you guys this because I've been open. I've been very transparent about my life. And so there's been days where I just don't feel anything at all. And so I've been pushing past that and working through that. And so that's been like the biggest thing right now. And so you got a combination of work, home, and past situations and stuff, all a combination of things. And so really I took a break of about 3 weeks to a month just to mentally unwind and get back to gaming and becoming a true gamer that I've always been. Like, I've been gaming for 30 plus years, and I got to a point where I was having the disdain towards the channel, and I didn't like that feeling. I felt like it was an unwanted possession. But I know that this is a platform that I've been given, and I'm grateful for the people that's been sticking with me even during these few weeks that I haven't posted anything. And I just cracked over 700 subscribers. At this point, I'm close to 750. And so with the crossing out of the partnership with Creative Nation and moving out and being more independent on my own, I said, I'm just going to change up some things. So really, I've been really, 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 really gaming, and that's been bringing back some old feelings, and I've just been diving in. Like this weekend, I spent at least 15 hours gaming, probably 5 or 6 one day, and then 5 or 6 the other day. A few, like Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, I did a lot of gaming because we really didn't go out much. I've been playing Rogue Galaxy just like crazy, crazy, crazy. This game here is just like one of those RPGs. I didn't even know nothing about this RPG until I started hearing about it on Justin, which is aka BizNES17, and Erica Sabo. She talked about it, and I just happened, and it's just one of those crazy coincidences or crazy situations. I just happened to walk in the store, and I saw the game, and I remembered all the hype that they put behind it. And I think I only got it for $10. So, yeah, I've been gaming on that. And I probably have put in about 30 hours. Games that I completed. And that's another thing. Dave from I'm a Game Geek, we was talking about that probably a month and a half ago. Or early in January, I think it was. About games we haven't even completed. And because we haven't done it in a while. We've been so busy buying games and doing stuff. And I actually have taken time to just stop buying games for a little while, and I've been devoting my time and efforts towards playing. I finished Saints Row 4, I finished Stick of Truth, I finished Ghost of Sparta, I finished Art of Fighting on the SNES, I finished what else have I finished that I was playing? Oh, I'm working on going back through Shank. I got a new controller for my 360, so I'm working on that. What else did I finish? I thought it was 4 games. I can't even remember right now. I'm trying to think. Oh, I got to play the demo of Life is Strange. And also another thing, I found a PS4 that's pretty much more towards what I want. And I put some money down on it, so probably in the next month or so, I'll have a PS4 finally. There's a few games that I'm definitely eyeballing. Of course, Mortal Kombat X, No Man's Sky, and what else? Oh yeah, Just Cause 3 and Uncharted 4 got postponed to next year, so hoping for some really, really good titles that's coming out this year, and just keeping my mind open to the possibilities of what may be and stuff like that. And another thing I've been doing too, to just spark up my spirits or keep my spirits up, I've been finding new retro channels and just watching people go back and do those things that I did in the beginning. And I even went back and watched some of my old videos, not for vain reason, for understanding as to why I'm doing this and why I love doing this. And I really have to say, I know I thank all those people and there's a ton of others, but I really have to say thanks to Sean, because Sean knows, Sean, which is Gannex. And if you don't know, and that's another thing I've been spending my time on, collection.com, just talking on blogs with other gamers and just diving in and just getting back to the pure essence of what I love to do. Recently picked up a copy of Resident Evil, the HD version. That just came out, I think, towards the end of last year. Really, really looks good. I mean, part one looks mind-blowing, because I never got to play the one on GameCube. So, you're just gonna get random thoughts right now, so just be brief with me and be patient with me. But yeah, Sean and I are, we kind of came from the same upbringing, even though our lives were parallel, meaning they were like separate from each other, we kind of grew up the same. So there's been a lot of correlation between him and I as far as how we grew up, and I really, really, really appreciate that, man. He's been like a trooper through some really dark, dark shit, and we just talked about it and just chopped it up, and man, we just started going in about some stuff, and it's really been good. But yeah, I just really wanted to just take time to kind of bring you guys up to speed of what I've been going through and what I've been experiencing. I really just, at the end of it, just got burnt, and I needed to just take time to get my thoughts together and just understand what's happening around me and why I love doing this. I mean, every day I kept thinking about the channel and I want to do a video, and I just said, no, I need to give myself some time, because I'm still not in a good place. I feel like I'm in a better place, like I'm starting to come out on the other side of things. And like I do a lot of walking, exercising and stuff like that, and it helps me. But yeah, it's been challenging. And then looking back on the channel and just looking at the results that I'm getting versus the results that I wanted, I'm a perfectionist, so I'm harder on myself than I am on anyone else. And so the results that I wanted, I wasn't getting, so it was frustrating. I look at other channels and I see progress, I see success, and so that's kind of defeating, and I had to learn how to deal with that. And so over this time, I've just been dealing with a collection of things. So I just wanted to bring you guys up to speed of what's been happening and what I've been up to. I've been waiting on a couple packages and stuff like that, because people still sending me stuff, and I just really am grateful for that, man. I just, you can't put those kind of things into words. So at the end of it, I'm really grateful, and I'm really grateful for the gaming community, and how they just embrace me into this thing. And like I said, here I am, close to 800 subscribers. I didn't even know that was gonna happen. I know it sounds cliche, but it's just one of those things when I've just picked up a camera and for the first time really just wanted to do something that I love to talk about. And so a lot of you guys have kept me inspired and kept me going, so I'm really thankful that. And but yeah, currently I'm still gaming like crazy. I'm still playing Rogue Galaxy. About 30 hours in. It's about 100 plus hours. Really awesome RPG. Great storyline, awesome characters. Developers of Level 5, same creators of Ni No Kuni and a few other excellent titles, RPGs, great JRPG, by the way, and playing Diablo 3. And Chains of Olympus right now. But anyway, tell me what's going on with you. Tell me how everything's going. What games are you currently playing? What games are you looking for this year? I know it's only March. There's been some delays. There've been some disappointments. But other than that, I'm Ice Spill 79. I'm out.